All right, so you're using Google Slides, right? You just finished your presentation. You want to send it out to the world, but you're not sure the best way to do that. Do you go into the upper right-hand corner and press Share, or do you go to File and select Publish to the Web? So we're going to go over both of those options, talk about how they work. They're each very different. And then by the time that we're done, you'll know which option that you want to use to send out your awesome thing that you made. So if you go up to File, the first one that we're going to talk about is called Publish to the Web. And we'll left click on this. And what this is preparing you to do is to essentially get a link back to Google Slides that's going to give just a slideshow. So let's leave this on link for now. We'll talk about embed in a second. We'll say advance this every 3 seconds. That's good, right? You can slow it down or make it faster. We want to start it as soon as the player loads and we want to loop it. So we want to restart it after the last slide. If you left click on publish now, it asks you to make sure it's okay because this will make it accessible to anyone. Click okay, and it gives you this link. So you can just copy this link and put it in a browser. That's what we're going to do. Or you can choose some different built-in methods here of sharing it. So you could email it right out from here or post it to your social media account. Let's do Control C to copy this link. And I'm going to just go to a clean browser that I have that's not logged into my Google account. We'll paste it in here. Hit enter. And there we go. It takes you directly into the slideshow. It starts advancing automatically like we chose. And it's going to loop at the end. As you move your mouse down, you do get a control panel here. So you could pause it. You can manually advance it or go backwards. Choose the slide. And if you think it's going too fast, you could even choose to slow it down here. So this is one option to publish your slideshow. If this is what you want, then we're done, right? You don't need any other options. But let's go back to Google Slides and talk about some of the other things that are going on here. So one is that you can just lock it down for people in your company. So maybe this is an internal presentation that you created. You only want people at Acme Corporation to view it. I'll left click on that. Or maybe you have an existing website and you wanted to embed it inside that website. So I left clicked on embed here and you just choose a size. We'll just say medium. Same options. And let's copy this code. So I highlighted it. I'll do Control C. And then you would go to the back end of your website where you can input HTML code. I have mine open. I'm going to delete what I had in here. That's from something else. And I'll paste that embed code that I just got. We're going to see what it looks like. So I'll left click on preview changes. And there it is. So you'll notice the differences from what I just did before. This is my website. So it has the navigation still on it. It doesn't take up the whole screen. So it becomes part of the website. It's embedded in this site. So this is still linked to Google servers. So if you changed it, this could change, but you do have control over it. So let's go back to Google Slides and talk about the other way to share this document. So if you want to control specifically who can see it and give them the interface. So when we use these share options, the person getting the link is going to see the file menu. They're going to see the toolbar. Going to see all these things on the left-hand side. All right, if that's what you want, then you want to be over at Share. So let's left-click on Share, and you get this simple menu. If you know exactly who you want to share it with, you can just type their email address in here. Next thing that you would do is control what access you're giving them, so you can give them full access, right? You can allow them to edit it, or you can just allow them to comment it. So if you want to send it to someone, you want them to review it, but you don't want them to make a change and you don't know about it, you can just change it to just comment, or you can just allow them to view. So once you select the level of control that you give them, you usually want to add a note in here, leave this click to notify the people, and when you click send, it will give them an email message telling them that they've been given access to this file. Other than specifying specific people, so I'll take that out. You can change how the link behaves for anyone that finds it. So I'll click on shareable link. We'll left click on advanced. And right now it's set to anyone at the company can view. So left click and change that. You can have this off, so only specific people can view. So that email address that you typed in, that's the only person that would see it. And as you move your way up these options, these become less restrictive. So if you have a company or a school account, you'll see these two options. You could say, hey, you know, anyone in my company can find it as long as they have the link, or anyone can find it, period, if they search for it. Or as you move your way up, you can just share it with anyone with the link. This last one just puts it public on the web. Let's talk about anyone with the link. So whatever you choose here, you have to remember to go to this dropdown and control what kind of access you're giving them with that link. Let's say we just want them to be able to comment. So since this is second level, they could view and comment, but they won't be able to edit. So let's left click on comment and click save. Here we go. So I have access, obviously, because I'm the owner of the document. And then I check that anyone with the link can comment. So let's copy this link. We'll do Control C. We'll click done. And then we'll go back to that other browser window that I have up. This is what we did before. This browser, remember, is not logged into my Google account. So this is anyone's browser on the street. If they got the link with the settings that you have there, this is what they're going to see. So you notice this is different than the behavior of when we published it. You see the interface. They have somewhat of a file menu, even though it's limited in what they can do. And all of these options are options that you can do when you can only comment on the file. So this is still a higher level of access than publishing the document, because when you publish it, you can't get feedback from the person directly through slides. But if you're doing it this way, and the person wants to leave a comment, they can right click, leave a comment, say this looks great, left click on comment, and then we'll come back into the browser where I created it and I'm logged into my Google account. You'll notice one thing happening here. You can see an icon of an anonymous person that's in here. Let's click done. And I see their comment came through. They just said this looks great, so there's nothing that you need to do. You know, you can smile when you get this. Oh, I feel good. But let's left click and resolve it so it goes away, because we just want to-dos listed here, right? So left click on resolve. And there we go. So I'll see you in the next video for a more in-depth tutorial on Google Slides. Thanks.